hemisphere. This is the last one. Right on solid sphere. See, in your in the school, the syllabus, as you see, they will directly tell you to remember these values of moment of inertia. They will not ask you to derive it, integrating and all that. Okay, but these methods, you must understand how to do it, because JEE likes to test you on the basics. They will create a hypothetical scenario where mass changes with length and find out moment of inertia of the rod now. So if you know how to exactly solve it, you will apply the same method to solve there as well. But if you remember the moment of inertia without knowing how it is coming, you will not be able to solve many such kind of questions. Solid sphere, paranoid sphere. You will assume that solid sphere is made up of disk. Disk of that, if you do it like this. Best is to assume it is made up of hollow spheres. Hollow sphere will expand its radius and cover the entire solid sphere. Got it? Okay. Suppose it is made up of hollow spheres. This is R and the width is dr. Can you find out integral of dI? By the way, what is dI? Over here, what is dI? Let's say mass of this hollow hemisphere is dm. So dI is what? Is it R square dm? No. It's a hollow sphere. So we have to integrate 2 by 3 R square dm. This you have to integrate. It's a hollow sphere, right? For hollow sphere, moment of inertia is 2 by 3 mR square. And the mass is dm now. Now try doing this your own. This is the last one. Get it yourself. The method is exactly same which we did to find the center of mass of the solid hemisphere. Just refer it back, do it yourself. How you find dm is same. How you find dm is same. And it is same not only for this chapter, it will be same for class 12 also. When you go and talk about charge and current and everything else, same way you have to follow. But you will learn now only. Capital R is the radius of the big sphere. Now the mass is distributed on surface or the length? It is distributed on volume. The solid sphere, right? So mass per unit volume you have to make. Mass per unit volume into volume of the hollow sphere's mass. Okay, some silly error you have done. Do what I want to do, right? How many of you got the answer? Yes. 2 by 5 mR square is the answer. How many of you got it? 2, 3. Should I do it or wait? Done. What is dm? Mass total volume is 4 by 3. Where 4 by 3? Pi r cube into what? 4 pi r square dr. When you multiply the volume of dm, you should not take volume inside dm. Volume of dm you have to take, which is surface area into width. Okay, pi m pi goes, 4 goes, 3 m by r cube r square dm. This is my dm. So here you can substitute r to the power 4, r to the power 5 by 5. So you will get 2.5 mR square. 2 by 5 mR square. Okay? Question? Any doubt? Alright, so till now we have done some basic integration to find out the moment of inertia of the some regular shape objects. Alright, but what is the issue? The issue is that moment of inertia of different axes is different for the same object. Okay, so I can't just keep on integrating for the same object for different axes and find the moment of inertia. So there has to be a way to find out moment of inertia of other axes knowing moment of inertia of one of the axes. So there should be a relation between the two axes. Fine. For that, we are going to learn two theorems which will relate moment of inertia of one axis with respect to the moment of inertia of other axes. Alright? Very straightforward, simple theorems. Alright? Please write down. I am going to done this topic, otherwise just 5 minutes topic, I should not leave it to the next class. Okay, let me finish this off. Please write down parallel action theorem. And it is there in KVPY, by the way. Let me write my KVPY. Listen. It's fixed rate. Why? Turn into one. Okay, parallel action theorem. So, draw a rigid body like this. This is a, need not be a regular shape. Fine? This is a rigid body. Okay? This is an axis that passes through the center of mass. This is an axis that passes through the center of mass. And moment of inertia above the center of mass is ICM, let us say. Okay? There is another axis. By the way, the axis need not pass through the object. So this, about this axis also the entire object can rotate. Entire object will rotate like this. Okay? So about this axis, let's say this is the another axis I. Both axes are parallel to each other. If I down ICM and I are parallel to each other and the distance between them is D. Written? Okay. So according to parallel theorem, I will be equal to ICM plus total mass of the rigid body into d square. Okay? This is parallel axis theorem. And what does it mean? Can I say that ICM is the least? This will always be a positive number. So moment of inertia about any other axis is always ICM plus a positive number. So moment of inertia or inertia against the rotation is least about the axis that passes through the center of mass. And how many such axes are possible? How many center of mass axes possible?
No, infinite.
Infinite. Infinite. Okay? And there can be different moment of inertia about different center of mass axes. Fine? But one thing is sure, if you are finding the least moment of inertia of all the axes possible, it must pass through the center of mass. Okay? There is a small proof of this. Let's assume this is your z axis, x, and let's say this is y. Let's assume that there is a mass here whose coordinates are x, y, z. Let's say mass is small mi, xi, yi, zi. Its perpendicular distance from the z is what? Root of x square plus y square. So moment of inertia, zx, which is also ICN, is summation of, write down, xi square plus yi square. Yes or no? Perpendicular distance is root over x square plus y square. Mi r square is mi into x square plus y square. Alright? Okay? This is the parallel axis to the z axis. This axis is parallel to the z axis. So, moment of inertia about that axis, what do you think this will be? Summation of mi into what will be its perpendicular distance from this axis? The axis is displaced along the x. What d? Perpendicular distance, its x coordinate will be reduced by d. Yes or no? So its x coordinate relative to this line will be xi minus d. Getting it? If d is exactly equal to x, the x coordinate for this line will become 0. Are you getting it? So it will be summation of xi minus d whole square plus yi square. It is displaced only along the x axis, and you can create such scenario. You can rotate your coordinate axis in such a way that it got displaced only along the x axis. Fine. Now expand this summation of mi xi square plus yi square is what you get. X square plus yi square plus b square summation of mi minus 2d summation of mi xi. Did you get this? Did you understand how this comes? Understood? I've just expanded and taken summation inside. These constant comes out of summation here and there both. Getting it? What is this? ICM? So I is equal to ICM plus what is this? D square into summation of all the masses is total mass. So M into D square. Now what is this? Summation of MI XI divided by summation of MI. This is what? X center of mass. Do you remember that? And what is X center of mass over there? Zero. Center of mass is at the origin. So this is equal to zero. So summation of mi xi becomes 0. So this term goes. This is the proof of parallel axis theorem. Perpendicular axis theorem proof is just two steps. This is next theorem, the last topic for today. Just two steps. Have you understood this? Topic on. Done. You should copy it down while I'm telling. Okay. What is the restriction in parallel axis theorem? One axis must pass through the center of mass. Are you getting it? You can't use it between the two axes and none of them passes through center of mass. The last topic for today focus perpendicular axis theorem. This is valid only for planar objects. What are the planar objects? Tell me. Planar object. A disc. square plate, a ring, all of the objects which entirely in a single plane are called the planar objects. Okay? So according to this theorem, first draw a planar object. This is a planar object. This can also be irregular shape. X, Y, Z. Moment of inertia about Z axis will be the sum of the moment of inertia about X and Y. Okay? There is no restriction that it should pass through center of mass. And please write down Z axis. Z axis must be perpendicular to the plane of the object. Iz is perpendicular to the plane. Ix and Iy can be in the plane, but Iz must be perpendicular to the plane. And there is a reason why they are called Ix, Iy and Iz. The reason is they are all mutually perpendicular to each other. Getting it? Okay, a quick proof of that. Let's say this is coordinate Xi, Yi. For mass mi, what is its perpendicular distance from the z axis? 0. This is z axis and this is the point xi comma yi. So root over x square plus y square is a perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance of a point from the z axis is always under root x square plus y square. We have been using it till now. It doesn't matter whether it is a plane or solid. Okay? So Iz is, please write down, summation of Mi okay? Are you still having torturing news in the topic? As soon as this topic gets over, all of you will die. I'm sorry. What is happening? Focus! You should happy that you are knowing parallax theorem, perpendicular theorem. Go and tell your friends. Listen. Today, just one step away from the proof. Okay? This is... Stop talking. What is this? Tell me, what is xi? Perpendicular distance of the point from which axis is xi? Y axis, summation of mi xi star is I by. And what is the yi coordinate from which axis is perpendicular distance? X axis. So this is your I by and that is your I x. Okay, so this is the proof of perpendicular axis theorem. Please write down oblique axis theorem. Just let me speak one sentence here. See, guys, this theorem is used quite often if Ix is equal to Iy due to symmetry. For example, if it is this, moment of inertia about any diameter should be same. So Ix is equal to Iy for a disk. And Iz is mr square by 2 anyways, you know it. So Ix plus Iy become 2 times Ix is mr square by 2. So about the diameter, moment of inertia is mr square by 4. Because this is mr square by 2 and these are 2 equal. So 2 times of this is equal to mr square by 2. This is equal to mr square by 4.